Everyone, it's me again, your favorite design lead. In my last tutorial, we looked into auto tracing some photos of butterflies and leaves to create a thank you card. But today, I thought it would be fun to see auto trace in action with lettering. So we are going to turn this into this cute label. Let's see how I did it. So first things first, let's create a custom size document. And here I'm going to use centimeters, because I'm Polish. Now hate 4 inches though. You can look them up in the upper left corner. I measured my jar and I know I want 4.5 by 9 centimeters. Let's add the pictures of my sketches. You can also use our camera import option. I want to make everything a bit smaller so I can work with it better. And let's use our new auto trace. In sketch mode, we have these 3 new options. I just want to ignore white, so let's disable the other 2. Adjust the contrast a bit. And that's it. By ignoring white, my vector path follows the contour of my sketch exactly and I don't need to do any more work with it. It's that easy. For the lettering, keep the same options and hit auto trace. You can see everything, it's cut out, there's one group. Amazing. Alright, now let's create a background layer. So place it at the very bottom, choose a color from your palette and just draw a rectangle that covers the artboard. My color palette is available to download below, by the way. Now I'm going to create another layer and move the berries there so it's easier to work with them. So I'm making the berries, I don't know, purplish? They are a darker color because they are going to be my background. Don't forget to hold down one finger when resizing. Lock it just to be safe. Then I'm making my text pink. And I want to center my text, adjust the size. It's quite big, I know, trust me, it will make sense later. And then let's play around a bit with the composition. Let's adjust the berries individually, because I'm a bit of a control freak, of course. Okay, I'm more or less happy with this, so I'm going to create my next element. The last layer is for text, and this is our amazing text tool. And I'm going to write a line, sugar-free. The jam inside the jar is not sugar-free, but you get the idea. And the extra text looked nice in contrast to the handwritten cherry and berry. So speaking of contrast, we are going to change the color to this nice bluish green. Now from the style tab, I'm making sure that I have Gilson's regular 7 points. The tracking could look better, so let's make it 2 points and then fit bounds to text size. Once all my elements are in, I'm going to make some more minor adjustments. I like how sugar-free just continues from the descender of the letter Y. Make sure you align all your stuff so it does not look too chaotic. And we are done, finally, yay! Even when I'm making simple design, I tend to tweak it over and over again. But it's all worth it, cause I'm sure you love the final result. Let us know what you think in the comments and tune in for my next tutorial on guess what topic? Auto trace, heh. See you then.